Welcome to the class of microwave course. So today we are going to discuss about the microwave antennas. So in this class we will learn about what is antenna and the antenna parameters and the type of antennas. So let's start with first, that is, what is antenna? So an antenna is a transducer that converts radio frequencies field into alternating current or vice versa. So the antennas are the objects that are used to convert the radio frequencies into the AC currents. So antennas are used for both sending and receiving the radio transmissions. So uses of these antennas are in wireless local area network, mobile telephony, the satellite communication. So the above 3 gigahertz dish antennas are used, whereas below the 3 gigahertz we have to use the other type of antennas. So let's discuss about the other parameters that are associated with antennas. So the parameters that are associated with antennas are, the first of all we will discuss about the operating frequency. So operating frequency is the frequency on which the antennas will operate. So frequency bands and channels are defined by ITU on which these antennas will operate. After that, the next part is the radiation pattern. So radiation patterns are depend upon the antenna's series, size and frequency. So these are of two type, copolar radiation pattern and the cross polar radiation pattern. So here in frequency congestion period, it describes the capability of the antenna to differentiate the unwanted signal. It means it removes the unwanted signal from the original information signals. So this is the radiation pattern. After that, the next part is the gain. So gain is a function of antenna's size and its unit is dBi, that is decibel over an isotropic radiation. So here the gain measures antenna directivity and electrical efficiency. So here it defined at three frequency, the bottom frequency, the middle frequency and the top frequency band. The next part is the half power beamwidth. So here the half power beamwidths refer to the peak effective radiated power of the main lobe. So here it is a nominal total width of the main beam at the minus 3 dB point and it tells the strongest part of the beam. After that, the next parameters are there also. The first is polarization. So here the polarizations define the orientation of the electric field that drives the signals or that helps in the transmission of the signal. So here the polarization may either be horizontal or vertical. So it may be there are many antennas like single and dual polarized version antennas that we use. So here in single polarized antenna, it respond to only one orientation, and we are dual polarized, it respond to both orientation and it has a high traffic handling capability. So next part is the interport isolation. So here the interport isolation is the isolation of multi-port antennas from each others. Like in dual polarized version antennas, there are two waveguide ports. So to isolate these multi-port antenna, that is the interport isolation. So here the isolation and electromagnetic separation between input port of a dual polarized antenna is done, and it typically 35 dB is the minimum, and it is also known as the port to port isolation. And here it produces the high isolation. Here the high isolation reduces the complexity and the level of filtering required at the antenna part. The next part is the front to back ratio. The front to back ratio, here the its unit is dB, that is decibel, and here the ratio of signal strength transmitted in a forward direction to that transmitted in a backward direction is taken. So here the EM waves are composed of both electric and magnetic field. So what we will do here, the ratio, we will take the ratio of the transmitted signals that in the forward direction and as well as in the backward direction. So the ratio denotes how much radiation is emitted behind the main beam at 180 degree plus minus 40 degree across the band. So this is the front to back ratio. The next part is the cross polar discrimination. So the cross polar discrimination, its unit is also decibel, and it defines how much of signal energy is transmitted in the correct polarization. It means it tells the ability to maintain radiated or receive polarization purity between horizontally and vertically polarized signal. So here it is difference between peak of the co-polarized main beam and the maximum cross polarized signal over an angle twice the 3 dB beamwidth of the co-polarized main beam. Next part is the VSWR, that is voltage standing wave ratio. So here it indicates the value of mismatch between an antenna and feed line connected to it. So it determines how efficiently the power is radiated between radio and antenna at operating frequency. So typically the VSR value is equal to 2, and it is considered as suitable for the most antennas application. So this is about the parameters of the antennas. So next part we are going to discuss about the type of antenna. So the type of antennas are like horn antennas, parabolic antenna, slot antenna, dipole antenna, and the next is the dielectric resonator antenna, and last one is the array antenna. So start with the first, that is the horn antenna. So horn antenna, so here in diagram we have showed the horn antenna. So horn antennas consist of flaring metal waveguide shaped like a horn, and it directs radio waves in the form of beam. So it is very popular at usage or at the ultra high frequency, that is 300 megahertz to 3 gigahertz. So it have a directional radiation pattern with the high antenna gain. So it is used as a feed antenna for a large antenna structure such as parabolic antenna and the directive antenna. So the usable bandwidth of antenna is 10:1, and it can be up to goes to the 20:1, and the gain of the antennas ranges between 25 decibel per isotropic region. So it is commonly used at the ultra high frequency. So horn antenna have little loss, so the directivity of horn is roughly equal to its gain. So this is about the horn antenna. Next we are going to discuss about the parabolic antenna. So these dish antennas are known as the parabolic antenna, and it is also known as the reflector antennas. So it named as parabolic reflector antenna, and it is also known as a satellite dish antenna. So it consists of a curved surface with the cross sectional shape of a parabolic like a dish. So it has a high directivity, and with highest gain it produces narrow beamwidth of 0.4, that is used for point to point communication. So it has a low loss of polarization, and the small dish will operate at the frequency of 2 to 28 gigahertz, whereas the large dish operate at the frequency of 30 to 300 megahertz. So it means these dish antennas or the parabolic antennas have the highest directivity, and they are used for point to point communication. The next part we are going to discuss about is the slot antenna. So here this diagram shows the slot antennas. So slot antennas consist of metal surface, usually a flat plate with one or more holes or slot cut out. So when plate is driven as an antenna by a driving frequency, the slots radiate EM waves in a similar wave that of the dipole antenna. So it is used at the ultra high frequency and the microwave frequencies. The next antenna is the dipole antenna. So here this diagram shows the dipole antenna. So dipole antenna is also known as doublet, and it is widely used for the communication purposes. So it consists of two identical conductive elements such as metal wire and the rods. So it commonly common example of this dipole antenna is rabbit ears television antenna found over the broadcast television set, and the current and associated voltage that causes EM waves to radiate in the here. And this short dipole, there are many type of dipole antenna, like the short dipole, half wave dipole, quarter wave monopole, and the folded dipole. So these dipole antennas are widely used for the purpose of communication and also used for the TV broadcasting. The next part of antenna we are going to discuss is the dielectric resonator antenna. So these are the very small antennas, and it is can be used at micro frequencies or the higher frequencies. So these dielectric resonator antennas consist of block of ceramic material of various shape. The dielectric resonator mounted on the metal surface A and the ground plane. So it is widely it has low losses, and it is affected to be used at a microwave as well as at the millimeter waves. So the radio waves are introduced inside of the resonator material from the transmitter circuit and bounce back and forth between the resonator walls and forms the sounding waves. So this is in this way these dielectric form the electromagnetic wave radiations. The next part we are going to discuss is the array antennas. So the array antennas is a set of multiple connected antenna which work together as a single antenna to transmit and receive the radio wave. So here the individual antennas are connected to a single receiver and the transmitter by a field lines. So these field lines feed the power to the element in a specific phase relationship. So the radio waves radiated by each individual antenna combines and superpose, adding together to enhance the power radiated in desired direction and cancelling to reduce the power radiated in the other direction. And at receiving end, the separate radio frequency currents from the individual antennas combine in the receiver with the correct phase relationship to enhance signal received from the desired direction and cancel signal from the undesired direction. It means there are a number of transmitter and receiver antennas that are mounted over the array antennas, and these array antennas are used to transmit the number of signals together as well as receive the number of signals together. So here the field line is connected to provide the power to these elements, and it has a higher gain and higher directivity. So this is all about the various type of antennas in microwave. So this is all about the antenna part in microwave course. Thank you.